Today we're going to talk about our HDPE or high density polyethylene products. This is a pretty common product that Formaspace sells, and it comes in a couple of different textures as well as a few different colors. So one is our textured product, and that's a fairly good looking product. It does scratch easily because one of the entire purposes of HDPE is that it's chemically soft. That makes it work very easy, so you can cut it into a variety of shapes. You can make cabinets out of it, as well as making work surfaces out of it. And if you're working with something really soft in an assembly application, maybe a circuit board, and you happen to drop it or mush it into the HDPE, it's going to ruin the HDPE surface before it ruins whatever you're working on. So it's typically used in some pretty highly specified either assembly application or a laboratory application. And the reason for a lab application is it also has great chemical resistance to a wide variety of chemicals. Now, it's not perfectly chemically resistant. There are a few things where it doesn't react that well. Chlorine, fluorine, petrochemical-based products like gasoline, and it doesn't react particularly well in temperatures over 100 degrees. Typically, they test HDPE at 70 degrees and 140 degrees, for a broad variety of chemicals and reagents. And in most of those cases, it performs more poorly at 140 degrees than it does at 70 degrees. So just something to know. So in addition to this textured product, we also have a high gloss product. And the high gloss product, just to make everybody aware, is not necessarily the most aesthetically pleasing product over time. Because of its soft nature, it pits and scratches pretty easily. In fact, even by the time you've received it, it's likely to have a few scratches just from the shipping and assembly process. So typically, the only reason to have a high-gloss HDPE is in a setting where you have to have it for some reason. Either you plan to do a lot of writing, you plan to really need to see in between the tiny little textured grooves, or it's the only product that's available for your particular use. And so that's kind of that's in the high spec realm, I guess you'd call it, of the products that we make. There are a few kind of crazy projects that HDPE gets used for. They're used in black ops projects where you can't have any vibration. They're used in band cabinets for the same reason. So if somebody's playing their saxophone and you don't want it to vibrate and cause that sound to be transmitted through a building, HDPE is used for that. As I said before, it's used in a lot of laboratory. You can also, Formaspace makes a product that is also ESD compliant in plastic. And you can work it in a million different creative ways, and our designers are great at that. They can put tracks in it, so in case you need to move something down a little track that's within the table from, say, one assembly cell to the next, that's a great reason for HDPE. And like I said, we have an ESD product that is, it's not HDPE, but it's something similar that we've created for those applications. And that is HDPE in a nutshell. So if you have any other questions about HDPE or any other of the work surfaces that you might be considering, visit our website at formaspace.com, our YouTube channel at Real Formaspace, or of course call one of our design consultants who'd be happy to help you.